Welcome to the channel. Today's project is going to be a smart door lock system using Arduino and voice recognition.
Please save the password.
781.
Thank you. Access granted.
Since this is a voice recognition project, I'll be using the MOVI voice control shield for Arduino boards. I've used this a couple times. I haven't used it in a while, but I thought I would come back and use it for a door unlocking or a lock unlocking project here. For this project, I'll have to say the proper password, and once it detects the correct password, the servo will unlock the lock and the green light will flash. If I give the wrong password, the red light will flash and the buzzer will sound, and I have three chances before Arduino shuts down and tells me to go away. Anytime the latch is locked, you'll see a red LED that's on. Anytime that it's open, you'll see a green LED that is flashing. The MOVI has two items connected to it here. One is a microphone. It's a simple lapel microphone that I have. And the other is a speaker. The speaker has to be an active speaker. It has to have its own amplifier. And I'm using the Unz Angle 3 Pro. The Unz Angle 3 Pro. It is a very nice speaker. So one that has its own amplifier will do. The servo motor has its own dedicated microcontroller here. Over the time using this MOVI board, MOVI shield, I've realized that it can be a very noisy shield. And if you just use the shield alone with the Uno underneath it, your servo will twitch and carry on erratically.
Door alarm simulator. Valid commands are lock door and open door.
You can see how it shakes around here. Arduino. Open door.
Please save the password.
So to prevent that, I used a dedicated Arduino Uno for the servo. It is connected by I2C communication so that you don't get all the extra noise, and it works much better. In order to get an I2C connection between the two, all you have to do is connect the SCL pin of this Arduino to the SCL pin of this Arduino, connect the SDA pin here to the SDA pin here, and then connect the ground pins between the two. We'll go over some of the connections here. We have a micro servo motor connected to a latch pin here. We have two LEDs. The green one is connected to pin 7. The red one's connected to pin 6. The piezo buzzer is connected to pin 5 on the primary Arduino. We move over here, we have the lapel pin. The lapel pin is connected to the mic port on the MOVI. And you can see that right here. Right next to that is the speaker auxiliary connection. And that is where you plug in your active speaker, your amplified speaker. Here we have the servo motor again. You can see that the VCC pin is connected to 5. The ground pin is connected to ground. And the signal pin is connected to pin 9 on the secondary Arduino. You can see here to the left, I have the I2C connection. The SDA is connected to the SDA. The SCL is connected to the SDL. SCL between the two. And then also connect those two ground pins between the two. And that should set you up for I2C. Here you can see the red jumper here. That's connected to the piezo buzzer. That is pin 5. The green one is connected to the red LED, and that is pin 6. The blue jumper is connected to pin 7, and that is also connected to the green LED. The purple jumper there connects the ground rail of the breadboard to the ground pin of the primary Arduino. Just so there's no confusion about the connections, here is a little diagram for you. I hope that helps. Here's the code for the main Arduino. This is the one that the MOVI shield is on. And you can get this MOVI shield on the website, the MOVI website. I will include that in a link in the description. I don't believe you can get it on GitHub, but I'm not sure. Like I said, I'll link that. So look for that link in the description for that library. This is the code that we used. And I just want to point out a couple things. I'm not going to talk about the whole thing. I want to mention line 10 here. 781, this is the password for this particular sketch. This is a string here that is the password. Anything you write in these parentheses is going to be your password. And down here at line 31, This line here is just adding a sentence to MOVI's speech recognition system that trains it to recognize that phrase as a valid phrase. So you want to write whatever word here phonetically so that it sounds correct when MOVI says it. As you'll find out, some words don't sound correct, so you have to spell them out phonetically. Earlier, my password was the Muffin Man, so I had to type that in here. If I didn't type that in here and that was my password up here, it wouldn't recognize it. So it also recognizes 781, and it recognizes that because 7, 8, and 1 are numbers in here. So that is important. This is the second code here, second sketch for our second Arduino, and it's the one with the servo connected to it. And if you look down here at line 8, you'll see a wire.begin8. That provides the code that initializes the I2C communication on the first Arduino with a specified address of 8. In I2C communication, each device connected to the bus, or in this case the Arduino board, needs to have a unique address to identify it. So the wire.begin8 statement sets that I2C address of the first Arduino to 8. And this means that the second Arduino, which acts as a slave device, will communicate with the first Arduino using this address. I hope that makes sense, but you don't actually need to connect anything to pin 8. And down here, you'll see that the servo signal wire is connected to pin 9, and it just hangs out and waits for a signal from the primary Arduino to say, hey, turn that arm on the servo. So this one's pretty simple, nothing to it. If you want these two sketches for your own project, check our Facebook page. It'll be posted there. You can see more details in the description below. Now I'll just show you an example of getting the password correct and getting the password incorrect three times. Arduino. Open door.
Please say the password.
The Muffin Man.
Thank you. Access granted.
Arduino. Locked door.
Door locked.
Arduino. Open door.
Please say the password.
Open sesame.
Invalid password. Try again.
Pickleberry pie.
Invalid password. Try again.
Pretty please.
Invalid password. Too many tries. Go away.